Greetings. I have some questions for every Muslim on earth to consider and answer for themselves. Which Quran is eternal? Now, a Muslim must respond by conditioning. There is only one version, the Arabic. And to this very day, this is the dogmatic claim of sincere but uninformed Muslims. You see, early on, Islam had to deal with different versions of the Quran. But I'm not going to cover Uthman's unification of the many versions of the Quran during his caliphate. Nor am I going to address the logical fallacy of the Quran being revealed in seven dialects, which is the excuse offered to explain all differences in versions of the Quran. I really only want to ask you, dear Muslim, about two versions of the Quran. Two and only two, a specific, associated pair of versions of the Quran. Though, according to the Quran, it is impossible for us to know how many pairs of Qurans there are. What are you talking about, Tex? This may be confusing to you, so let me back up a little and be more clear. There is a teaching in the Quran called abrogation. Abrogation is the teaching, or excuse, of Muhammad claiming any part of the Quran may be lost or forgotten at any time. But do not panic, because the author promises to introduce a change that is at least as good as the former content. But let's hear Muhammad himself, the prophet, give you the bad news himself. Surah 2:106, Yusuf Ali translation. None of our revelations do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we substitute something better or similar. Knowest thou not that Allah has power over all things? Remember, Muhammad claimed to be delivering someone else's words, so our, as in our revelations, must be ascribed to the claimed source. The Shakir translation. Whatever communications we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, we bring one better than it or like it. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? The Al-Muntakab. They question, O Muhammad, the wisdom of abrogation in certain circumstances. None of our revelations or signs, secondary in character, do we terminate, but we replace it with a better or equivalent substitute. Do you not know that Allah is Qadirun, omnipotent to affect all things? The monotheist group. We do not duplicate a sign or make it forgotten unless we bring one which is like it or even greater. Do you not know that Allah is capable of all things? Notice the way the monotheist group rewrites the order into the proper logical ascent. Replace it with the same or even greater. That builds or increases in logical value. The other order, the true order that Muhammad or Allah came up with, screams that the second phrase is a consolation. Just missing the words of justification, at least it will be as good. It will be better, or, well, at least it will be like or as good as it was before. See how flaccid? See the lack of confidence in that presentation? The true order that Muhammad or Allah came up with screams failure and appears to be the rationale missing the necessary phrase, at least, as a justification. Keep that in mind as we mull this ayat in other translations. The Ali Kuli. For any verse that we abrogate or remove from memories, we bring another which is better than it, or, at least, similar to it. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? That's the Texas translation contribution, at least. The Bilal Muhammad. Whatever we cancel out of an ayat, practice or ritual, or we make it forgotten, we come with better than that, or the like thereof. Don't you know that Allah is all assessing to everything? Kamal Omar, none of our revelations do we allow to be lost, but we substitute something better, or, at least, similar. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? Just think how naturally the words "at least" fits into the rationalization. Make no mistake, the leaders and teachers of know abrogation creates a damning problem for Islam. And to attempt to address it, they have created several excuses to try and handle or manage the problem of abrogation. One is to try to explain away abrogation as something that only applies to the Torah and Bible. And this thought, while not universal, is common enough. A translator has actually included it in his translation. The Ahmed Ali, when we cancel a message sent by an earlier prophet, or throw it into oblivion, we replace it with one better or one similar. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? See how the translator has added words to include his own pet theory and interpretation, sent by an earlier prophet. That would seem to be a clear defense of the Quran, right? Muhammad is the last, so he is earlier than none. If you buy that, you can easily accept abrogation cannot apply to the Quran. But then we have another clear translation like this. The Farouk Malik. We do not abrogate any of our verses in the Quran or cause it to be forgotten, except that we substitute it with something better or similar. Don't you know that Allah has full power over everything? And strangely, no parentheses are added to indicate translator insertion. But you can check the Arabic, and the word Quran is not there. So, besides abrogation being a recognized serious problem for the Quran, it is confusing. The Muhammad Mahmoud Ghali, in no way do we abrogate an ayah, verse, or sign, whatsoever, or cause it to be forgotten, except that we come up with, bring, a more charitable one, or the like of it. Do you not know that Allah is ever determiner over everything? Different translators obviously feel the need to add words to explain and clarify what it might mean. The Muhammad Sarwar, for whatever sign we change or eliminate or cause to recede into oblivion, we bring forth a better sign, one that is identical. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? This word, identical, makes no sense as an extrapolation of interpretation. Identical means exactly the same, which is no measurable difference or change in any way. But I am talking about an entirely different consideration. I'm talking of the two versions of the Quran caused by abrogation. One version is the Quran before the abrogation. The other version is the Quran after the abrogation of the previous version. It's kind of like an abrogation sandwich. We have an older Quran, version number one in this, and then for some reason there's a problem and Allah must abrogate, so there's an act of abrogation. And now suddenly, we have a new version of the Quran. Version number two. In fact, every act of abrogation creates a pair of Qurans that orbit the abrogation. The Quran before Allah abrogated ayats and surahs, and the Quran after Allah added new ayats and surahs. Call them before and after, if it helps you remember. So if any abrogation has ever occurred, there must be two different versions of the Quran. And neither of the two Qurans can be called eternal. The old Quran is now lost and forgotten, and therefore, logically, it is not eternal. The new Quran did not exist before the abrogation, and therefore, logically, is not eternal either. That is bad. Abrogation irrefutably condemns the claim of an eternal Quran. But there is an even worse dimension to this problem for the eternal, unchanging Quran. Do we know how many times Allah has abrogated the Quran? How could we even know if it was abrogated, since Allah caused the past version of the Quran to be forgotten? If you read Surah 2, 106, you will see that the author claims Allah has the power to do this. Why does Allah even need to claim abrogation of the Quran when a true deity should have been able to get it right the first time? This is not about gradual revelation, because abrogation is not about gradual revelation. Abrogation is about changing and replacing previous revelation in the Quran. And every case of abrogation creates an additional, new version of the Quran. Mathematically, if abrogations are represented by A, the number of Quran versions is equal to A plus 1. This is about changing already revealed surah and ayat, just because Allah claims to be able to do so. The Pickthall: nothing of our revelation, even a single verse, do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten, but we bring in place one better or the like thereof. Knowest thou not that Allah is able to do all things? Notice two different ways Allah abrogates and changes His Quran. Nothing of our revelation do we abrogate or cause to be forgotten. Abrogate is to repeal or do away with, to supersede. Cause to be forgotten. Forgotten means lost, to not be remembered. Gone from memory. And that aspect completely undermines every claim by Islam that the Quran was memorized. That you could destroy every copy of the Quran on earth and the Muslim memory of it could bring it back. Not when Allah has the power to make you forget what it previously said, brother. But it is also possible only one way is being offered, with two descriptions to help explain what is going on. Allah really changes the Quran simply by making Muslims forget what it used to say. Like saying if we abrogate a verse, or for example by causing it to be forgotten. So the second clause is attempting to explain the first, not offer a second different mechanism. The Wahidudikan: if we abrogate a verse or cause it to be forgotten, we will replace it by a better one or one similar to it. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? Al-Muntakab: I like to call him Al-Muntakab the Wordy. They question, O Muhammad, the wisdom of abrogation in certain circumstances. None of our revelations or signs, secondary in character, do we terminate, but we replace it with a better or equivalent substitute. Do you not know that Allah is Kadirun, omnipotent, to affect all things? This Al-Muntakab character seems to add lots to Allah's words. We do not duplicate a sign or make it forgotten, unless we bring one which is like it or even greater. Did you not know that Allah is capable of all things? The Ali Kuli Kure: for any verse that we abrogate or remove from memories, we bring another which is better than it or similar to it. Do you not know that Allah has power over all things? So I must ask Muslims to answer, which version of the Quran is eternal? Is the one before the abrogation eternal? It cannot be, because that version has been changed and forgotten, and Allah claims to be able to do so. Or is the Quran after the abrogation now eternal? It cannot be, because that version did not exist before Allah made his changes, and it will not exist after the next abrogation, which could come at any time. So is the Quran after the abrogation now eternal, at least until the next abrogation? It then shares the fate of every previous incomplete and incorrect version of the Quran. So I must ask Muslims to answer for themselves, which version of the Quran is eternal? An honest examination of the doctrine of abrogation means that no version of the Quran can be eternal. But you, O Muslim, must decide for yourself if you desire and respect honest critical examination of the Quran and its teachings. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.